Okay, let's start with understanding that there are two sets of knowledge, the Western civilization and Eastern civilization. So from Eastern civilization, I'm just going to explain this yin and yang, which is the simple combination of light and darkness and the effect that the moon may have or the sun may have to cause this effect, and also why it also makes it all rotate magnetically afterwards. The four elements that we see from the western side is simply fire, earth, water, and air. So if we start just from this simplistic view, fire, earth, water, and air, then we can realize how things rearrange themselves depending on which element they really are. So for instance, we could say that from earth, we could create Germany with the same type of onyx, same material, but rearrange differently. And then if we were to look at in water, what would onyx rearrange itself to be? Well, maybe it would be a cocoa beach marble, and then in a shape of Saudi Arabia. Or maybe in air, it could be just like so thin that you could see through it. Just like sand is carried by the air, silica. So, or you could have it from fire and then end up with something made up like Italy, because there's more fire to the deal, and that would give it this red hot appeal. Just like the light or the sun is really the red hot that we're looking at. And that would be the energy. This would be just the earth, the water on the earth, and then the air on the earth. Now, how does that work with the moon? Well, the moon pulls, let's say that this big pile of books is the moon. And we'll be in the shadow of the moon for a minute to explain this. The moon will pull on the water, and between the water and the stratosphere, there is air. So you can compress a gas, but you cannot compress a liquid. So this pushes the air further up, and eventually, when the moon moves out of the way, that pushes the water back down and the air back down. Why does the water fields also pull back down? Because the core of the earth is iron, which is magnetically and electrically charged, since that's where through which the magnetosphere of the earth goes. And each molecule of water has a polarity. So all of that gets pulled and then pushed and pulled and pulled, you know. And this is this interaction that kind of makes the earth breathe. So let me not make too long of videos and move on to the next thing.